the Philippines! Edward Landslide Folayang! And when the action begins, your referee in charge, Mr. Olivier Coste.
All right, guys, watch out for the headbutt. Low blow, back of the head and spine. You both know the rules. Five fair, five clean. Touch guard if you want. Back your corner.
Final instructions. Olivier Coste here in Manila. Mall of Asia Arena. The national hero, Folayang. And that man, Marquez, from Brazil, trying to rain on the parade, judge, spoil the party judge, here tonight in
judge
the Philippines.
Time. Ready? Ready?
The bell in round one. Three final rounds in the lightweight division. Two men willing to stand and throw leather. Snapping a jab early is Edson Marquez, 34 years of age, from Brazil.
Edward believes he's going to have the advantage and speed and footwork. And he doesn't think that Edson's going to be able to keep up with the pace that he wants to set, but Edson spent a lot of time out there in Brazil working with some high-level Iranian wrestlers and some Cuban boxers to put together a great team for this camp. So both these guys are feeling it. It's just the top of their game. And Edward is immediately starting to throw those leg kicks and tattoo the lower leg of Edson Marquez.
Yeah, well, he's throwing these leg kicks. He needs to get his head offline. Keep in mind that Edson Marquez has a 6-inch reach advantage with those arms, so he can reach out and touch him off his legs.
In our fighter meetings this week with Folayang, he told us he still has the power, he still has the fire, he still has the excitement every time entering the one circle. He's accomplished so much, he could easily hang it up, but still feels like he's got a ton left in the tank, even at 39 years of age.
You got to keep in mind, Brent, that Edward Folayang has fought the very best of the lightweight division for a decade now. He's never had an easy fight. He's always in there against the best of the best. And again, with Edson Marquez, who is just on a tear right now and looking real sharp. Good pressure coming from Marquez to try to control that distance and that range.
Yeah, Marquez using these little feints. He's freezing Edward right now. Edward's got to move. Can't allow himself to just get stuck in these positions with his feet planted on the mat.
Yeah, like there's that right hand landed by Edson because Edward didn't get his head offline when he threw that leg kick. So he's got to put something in front of that leg kick, too. He doesn't want us to throw a blind. But I like him going up top because if he's throwing head kicks and body kicks, it's going to be harder for Edson to really react the same way he was to that low kick.
Yeah, I saw Edson right there lining up for the uppercut. And Edward's going to have to start using a bit more feints, disrupting the nervous system of Edson Marquez, getting him off, you know, freezing him or whatever, because Marquez is just waiting for that timing right now.
Marquez is looking fast with his defense, too. You know, he's able to evade a lot of these kicks, but I think just Folayang hasn't really quite settled into his range yet and found that distance where he can start to land some of those punishing leg kicks he likes.
And here the crowd getting behind Folayang, who unleashes a flurry right there.
Yeah, but he ate a hook. He ate a lead hook while doing that.
Comes in a straight left, and then back out. Willing to trade here with Marquez. Throw a couple and take one there. 2 minutes to go round one. Again, the bout judged as a whole. Snapping the jab again, Marquez.
Wouldn't mind seeing a takedown from Edward as well. He has a really good blast double, chains attempts together nicely. He's also good inside that clinch when he gets that body lock, too. So just to give Edson something else to think about.
Spinning back kick attempt, Folayang showing everything in his arsenal here in round one. A call to the left there. Leather to the face of Folayang.
Yeah, Edson's been able to find some touches. Nice, short, crisp punches. Been able to score on Folayang.
He's got some pop in that jab, no doubt about it, Marquez. 1-2 there, Folayang. Folayang with overhand left.
Nice. That right hand is on a home right there now.
Yeah, I like the way he threw it, too. He came forward with his right foot, stomped down as he came forward. Changed stances there. He threw that right hand.
Spinning back kick, Marquez. Minute to go. Listen to this crowd here in Manila. Behind nice Folayang.
Chad right there snapping the head back. That silenced the crowd real quick.
Well, Folayang got caught with that jab because he got planted on those feet. He's not moving.
40 seconds, round one.
Folayang likes that big left hook to straight right hand to the body. Hasn't quite landed quite cleanly yet, but there's Edson working into that clinch, which you were speaking about.
Folayang hasn't landed that combination yet because of the height difference, because of the reach difference. He's got so much ground to cover in order to throw that 3-2. And, you know, Marquez, it gives Marquez plenty of time to react there. Like, Marquez is already out of range, and so he's got to find a way to systematically close that distance with micro foot movements before he actually decides to explode and unload.
Hard left. What a way to close the opening round by Edson Marquez.
Yeah, that right hand landed cleanly by Marquez there at the end, and
Edward keeping Edward Folayang back from exploding forward. But, you know, Folayang, he's always dangerous. You got to be careful here because, you know, does a good job of evading that punch, hitting the spin kick. But this is what I was talking about right here, about him not moving and getting planted and getting hit with that jab. And this is that final right hand that rocked him towards the end there, wobbled him a little bit, I'm sure. But that's going to score on the judges' cards.
Ben, set up for that. 1-2, 1-2, 1-2.
Set up your leg and 1-2, 1-2.
Folayang's looking a little bit wild with his punches. Kind of reaching for things, over swinging. Marquez is a little bit tighter, a little bit shorter with his punches, coming straight down the pipe. So Edward needs to tighten things up a little bit.
That's the benefit of him, of the height and reach advantage that Marquez has, because he doesn't have to make those big lunging motions forward in order to touch his opponent. You know, Folayang, and this is what I was talking about in the first round, he's got to use those micro foot movements to close the distance little by little systematically and then explode once he's already close enough to actually hit.
Spinning back kick by Marquez. He's shown everything in his arsenal early on as we open up this second round. Lightweight MMA division here in one championship. A 1-2 from Folayang. And then the inside leg kick got him a little bit high. And timeout here. An opportunity for Marquez to gather himself.
I love Marquez here. He's not on camera, but he's apologizing to the crowd. You can see this here. He just steps in. It comes right up the middle. You can actually hear it when it happened live, too. I immediately made that face like, oh. I'll just say this for the crowd, if you've never been kicked in the groin, a lot of people think like, oh, you're wearing a protective cup, so you should be okay. But oftentimes when you get hit in the bottom of that cup actually lifts up and catches things as it's coming in, and there's still a tremendous amount of pain.
All right, back to action. Tremendous respect for both fighters. Here in round number two, feature bout of the lead card. Main card comes your way exclusively on Prime Video, top of the hour, 10 p.m. Eastern in the United States.
There's that step forward right hand again thrown by Folayang. It looks like that inside leg kick is doing better work than his outside leg kick. But he's just throwing the kicks one at a time, right? There's nothing following up with it. He's just touching him. Scoring points, though. But he needs to start doing a little bit more to earn some of the respect. Nice little head kick there, combination thrown by Marquez as Marquez was able to turn around and press him up against the wall.
I like the head positioning right there by Marquez, being able to break away without taking any kind of damage, taking Folayang's balance as they were disengaging.
Back to the center of the one circle, push kick from Marquez. 3:20 in round two. The left to the body from Marquez.
I know Folayang told us that he had a speed advantage, but it seems like Marquez is a little bit sharper with the footwork, nice and light on his feet, doing a good job of just staying just out of range of Folayang.
Folayang that time a little out over his skis on a 1-2. And back to the center. Midpoint of the fight. 2.5 here in round two. Folayang from here in the Philippines, Marquez from Brazil.
Nice little stomp to the thigh there. A little bit of hyperextension of the knees on Edward.
Body kick from Edward. And a 1-2. Edward going on top of the right.
Looking in his eyes that he's staring blankly. He doesn't know where he is right now.
Another one of those short, clean right hands. Just found the mark nice and tight. Beautifully executed off of the turnaround. Found the angle. Boom. Put down the legend.
That's what that reach advantage does for you, though. It's causing Edward Flagg to continually overcommit on these shots and leaves him right open. Gage, Folayang comes forward, and then boom, right there. And Marquez's feet are still underneath him. He doesn't even have to lunge forward or anything. Watch, he evades this. He gets Edward Folayang gets himself overextended out of position. Easy shot for Marquez.
Face plants the legend, Edson Marquez. Woo.
Marquez, a serious power as advertised coming in. We knew they would stand and strike. It lived up to the billing. To make it official, Dom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coste, has called a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 53 seconds in the second round. For your winner, by way of technical knockout, Edson Marquez!
So Marquez in the second round with a huge right, face planting.